फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। इफ़ यू आर वाचिंग माय वीडियो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द डिज़ाइन ऑफ स्टील स्ट्रक्चर्स पार्ट टू। नाउ कमिंग टू टुडेज टॉपिक, वी विल ट्राई टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग व्हाट आर दीज रोल्ड स्टील सेक्शंस। जनरली द स्टील ऑफ एनी शेप एंड साइज कैन नॉट बी कास्ट ऑन साइट जस्ट लाइक एज दैट ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट, because in order to make such things, the steel needs very high temperature to melt it and roll it into required shape. For this, the sections which are readily available in the market and which are frequently used are known as rolled steel sections. So these rolled steel sections are nothing but which are readily available in market is nothing but called as a rolled steel sections. Okay, now how to get these details means the rolled steel sections details are in your steel table book. See, steel code is different, steel table is different. In the steel table, the details, the geometrical properties and properties will be available in the steel structure, just like its weight, cross-sectional area, width, thickness, like that everything will be available in the steel structures. So before buying, when we are going for the design only, we will be choosing the section from that steel table. Based upon that one, if we get a safer value, then we will be going to buy from the market. So based upon the required data, we are going to buy the product. So this is regarding the steel structures. We'll see some of the common rolled steel sections are rolled steel I sections. Next, channel sections. Next, angle sections. In these angle sections, you will be having equal angle, unequal angle, equal angle and unequal angle. Next, T sections. All these are rolled steel sections only. Next, steel bars. Bars, these are solid. And steel tubes are hollow, steel tubes which are hollow sections. Next, plates, flats and sheets. All these are nothing but some of the rolled steel sections. Now how they are designated means they are designated with respect to weight. How they are designated in the steel table is with respect to weight and series, depth and etc. These are the designations of the rolled steel sections. Coming to I sections, these will be used as a beams, and channel sections, multiple minimum two channel sections can be used as a column members, compression members, minimum two. And equal and unequal angle sections are used in case of a trusses, roof trusses. What is this equal and unequal means? Both legs are same means that is equal. One leg is higher and lower, other leg is lower, means it is a unequal angle sections. Next, these are T sections. Generally we'll be using at the junctions. And steel bars, solid one, they are solid means just like our reinforcement bar rod. Next, tubes, generally we'll be using these hollow steel tubes for rails of our staircase. Okay, next, flats, plates, sheets will be there, and we'll see one by one what are these different things, how they are designated. Now if I go for the classification of these rolled steel I sections, They are generally categorized as Indian Standard Medium Beam, Indian Standard Junior Beam, Indian Standard Lightweight Beam, Indian Standard Heavy Beam, Indian Standard Wider Flange Beam. And how they are shown in the steel code is ISMB 300 at the rate 422 Newton per meter. Means that section per meter length is how much? 422 Newtons. This ISMB 300. What is this 300 means? Its depth. Its overall depth means, suppose this is a I section. If it is I section, from here to here it is how much? 300. That is its overall depth. Similarly, second classification, that is channels, is Indian Standard Junior Channel, Indian Standard Lightweight Channel, Indian Standard Medium Channel, and Indian Standard ISSC means Indian Standard Special Channels, Indian Standard Special Channel. And moreover, sometimes these rolled steel I sections can also be used as a channel sections also. The only thing is placing is different. If I place a I section as a horizontal, it will be used as a flexural member, and if I use that I section as a vertical, we can use it as a compression member. Similar way, this angle sections I already mentioned you, equal and unequal, means how they will be, means ISA, Indian Standard Angle Sections, 90 by 90 by 6 mm, this is equal angle, whereas ISA 90 by 60 by 6 mm, this is unequal angle. Okay, this is unequal angle. Coming to the T sections also, they are also classified as Indian Standard Junior T section, Indian Standard Light T section, next Indian Standard Heavy Flanged section, like that ISST, Indian Standard Special Legged T section. You will be having this difference. Now we'll see what are these fifth classification. Now if I go for the classification of steel bars, those are solid one. Now ISRO 16 and ISRO 20. What is this ISRO 16 means? Indian Standard Round Bars. These are what? Round bars of 16 mm dia. Indian Standard Square Bars of 20 mm size. Side of the that one is 20 mm. So like that the designation will be. And the designation of tubes will be hollow tubes, that's steel tubes hollow will be generally how there will be, means as per their weight, light, medium and heavy. How they are designated by what we call its nominal size, nominal bore size. Suppose this is the hollow portion considered. So this bore size, this is the bore size will be considering. Next, suppose if I go for seventh A, this is A and B and C. 7A means what is that? Plates, rolled steel plates, means they are designated by ISPL with L into B into T. Now how they will be writing? Suppose L 2000 by 1000 by 60 mm, like that. Whereas 7B, it is flat. Flat means only you will be having width and thickness. They are designated by width and thickness. Okay, like that. And see, Indian Standard flat sections will be saying, right, 200 by 8 mm, like that. Means length it will be much more, whereas plate means you will be having three dimensions, and whereas flat means you will be having the width and the thickness only. Whereas the third one, sheet, it will be designated with what? Width and thickness. It's width and thickness. Now generally flats will be almost greater than 5 mm always, and we call this as a sheet if it is less than 5 mm. So this is regarding the what? Rolled steel sections. Next, we'll try to cover what are the design methodologies we'll be adopting in the steel structures design, methodologies, in DSS. Okay, so earlier we are supposed to use the working stress method. Already I told you that the working stress method code is IS 800 only, but it is 1984. Here the design is based upon service loads only, service loads, and because of that one uneconomical section means what will be developed means of larger size. Okay, because why it is happening is we consider its yield strength is its limit, the limit of the particular member as its yield. Suppose we are talking with steel, right? So steel will be having ultimate strength, even though it is having Fu of suppose of 410, we will be considering that as a 165. That is its limit in the limit strength. That is the reason we are going to develop a huge structure which is uneconomical section. Okay, even though we are considered, because if we are considering its limit, it will be accepting more loads, but we are limiting to, actually it can take up to Fu, but we are limiting to Fi. Because of these only uneconomical sections are getting developed. Okay, and here this theory is also is based upon, also called as a elastic theory concept we are considering here. And coming to the here, allowable stress equals to what? The stress by some factor of safety. Okay, whereas permissible stress equals to yield stress by factor of safety. We have seen earlier what is the yield stress. Okay, so in the next video we'll try to discuss about the main concept of this methodology, that is limit state method of design as per IS 800 2007. Thank you for watching my video. For more updates, please subscribe, like, share and comment.